So that's the Eurostar bringing people from the continent here to London for the Olympics. And if you're in London, you can't go far without seeing these. Now, the Olympic rings are pretty cool, but they're joined in a bit of a disappointing way, each one joined to the one next to it. It's not very creative. Here at Numberphile, we like our rings joined in a bit more of a clever way.
We all know how two rings can be linked. So if I got one ring, and I can link it with another one. And that's how I can start to form a chain. And I can't pull those two rings apart. But the cute idea of a Borromean ring is that you end up with three rings. Let's see if I can draw. So that's going to be my first ring. And my second ring isn't linked to it. Draw it like that. See, that one, if I'd filled in the gaps, would be just sitting on top of this one. And then I put a third ring in. Now, this third ring is going to go underneath my first one and over my second one. Now, if you made that out of physical pieces of metal, you'd find that you couldn't pull it apart, because take any two of those rings and it looks like they could be pulled apart, but the third one acts as some sort of tie, joining them together in a way that they can never be physically expanded. And I've got one here. I took a course in silversmithing some years ago so as to make things like this. And here we have three rings. Let's arrange it like that so they're each at 90 degrees to each other. And each one goes outside one ring and inside the other. But as you go round the rings, one, two, three, each is inside, outside, outside, inside, and so on, so that the whole thing holds together and you can't take them apart. So this is an example of what mathematicians called a higher linkage. So this is a more complicated way in which three things can be bound together than the two rings. No two rings are linked together in this sense.
Does this only work with the number three?
No. Once you start playing with these things, you realise you can make a corresponding entity out of any odd number of rings. It has to be odd. Yes, it gets a bit fiddly if you try to go beyond five, unless you're making it much bigger. The other thing that you might want to know about it is that this is much more familiar as a braid. And everyone knows how to braid three strips, three wires. So if I had three ropes and I braid by taking the middle one, putting it over one of the outer ones, and then I will swap over. I've done this wrong, haven't I? So by that stage, I've swapped everything round once. I got two overlaps under. I'm nearly back to where. So if you chase this blue one, this first blue one, so it's gone all the way over to the other side and all the way back. So this one is an under. This other outer one, gone all the way around here, and that's come back to its end. If I now joined it up, if I soldered this end to this end, and that end to that end, and that end to that end, I'd have three rings, and they'd be linked in exactly the same fashion.
I tell you what I take from that. I think the professor's much better at making rings than he is at braiding hair.
Yes.
If you want to see a bit more about interlinking rings, I've actually done another video just last week about how chemicals can link like this as well. Hopefully floating there, you can see a little preview of the video and you can click on it, and there'll also be a link under the video. So have a look at that one also. So I'm here in London and I'm gonna beat up Henry. No, right, no.